Good morning. Welcome back to the channel, lads and ladies, and I am pretty tired. I still have, I don't know, pneumonia or bronchitis or whatever the heck. My lungs have the fluids. I make the god-awful sounds in my breathemification tract, and we watch MetaDave from the Cone Cult playing the Mouse Tank. For those of you that are not aware, this is a vehicle that belongs in the regular tech tree of the German line at 7.7 rank. What is this? Rank 4, rank 5, something like that. But it was removed for players who have not made progress on the vehicle. That's right, the iconic, the famous Mouse Tank, not available to many players of the Game of War Thunder, but of course that's old news. You've heard it before, no doubt, loyal fan. You've heard it on this channel before, and yet, I tell you, the moment that we stop talking about the disappearing of the mouse is the moment that we accept this tyranny, and I say nay. I say thee nay, sir. Yes. We will not go quietly into that good night. I've got a cold. I mowed a lawn today, which it's not like a single lawn, it's like three lawns. It's a small apartment complex, and I get paid a small amount of money to mow that lawn, and I did not want to today, but it's one of the few sunny days that we have here on the coast, so I needed to make grass clippings while the sun shined, as it were. And then I tried to go to sleep, and all I did was lay in bed and cough up fluids from my lungs, which is just as fun as that sounds. So, sitting here in front of my computer, having taken a couple of Tylenol and a couple of melatonin, which are a natural sleep aid, non-habit forming, I'm led to believe, I'm very sleepy, and I'm very silly, and I'm very distracted, and this reminds me of the good old days. So we're gonna watch good old Dave hold the line here, and that's exactly what he's going to do for the rest of this replay. And I tell you, there are a couple more snippets lined up for you. If this here thought box was not enough for you, I say that there is more indeed. And if I sound a little bit weird, it's again, I have a chest cold, and I'm very, very sleepy. My wife, my beautiful wife, is on the couch behind me, where she collapsed, as is her custom, shortly after getting home from work, shortly after getting some dinner. And need I remind you that I mowed a large lawn today? It probably took me about 2 hours, all said and done, to do that project. And that was some, that was some physical manual labor for me. But it's also a labor of love for my wife, because this is my video games money that I go and earn by mowing lawns. That's right, I actually pay for everything in War Thunder that is premium content. I pay with my own money. I don't make anything at all off of YouTube. I'm not part of the partnership program. I have applied. My channel's too small. But Let's talk about Wally. He's sitting there, deer in the headlights, as MetaDave in the very German mouse, definitely not teamed up with the Americans. And yet, Wally here, trying to make a friend, I guess. I'm really not, I have no words. AFK? Well, he's out of the match now. MetaDave made a decision and yeeted him out of existence. where was I going? Right, I was talking about my incredibly attractive and precious wife who worked super ridiculously hard today because she works at the post office. She works very long hours, and she's good at what she does. She always gives 100%, and today was Tuesday, but it was also the day after a federal holiday. So what does that mean? Well, first off, it means that she had Monday off, but like the trooper that she is, instead of relaxing at home on Monday, she went into town. We live in a very small town. I like to think of it as like a large village because there's no shopping here. But if you're looking for like livestock, you know, maybe this is the place. But she went into the real town that's, what, like 40 minutes drive away, and did some grocery shopping and those things that keep this house in the food, which is highly appreciated by myself as I make it my life goal to never, ever, ever leave my house. Sort of the way that Dave is not leaving the cap zone here. Who knows what color this circle will change if I set foot outside my comfort zone. And so she had a huge day on Monday. Instead of relaxing, she went on an adventure, a shopping adventure. Not as relaxing as it sounds. And then today, she worked crazy hard because anytime the post office is closed for a day, people just bring twice the amount of mail and packages to the post office on the next day. And today was no exception. So she worked her little fanny off today. She's obviously pregnant at this point, so she's a truck driver for a baby now as well. And a little baby boy. We're gonna name him Joshua. He's coming out in June, and we're all super excited. Little Brooklyn, my two-year-old daughter, is starting to take the hint that she's gonna have a baby brother, and she's been playing with a little baby doll, and it's like the cutest thing in the world. Cause she'll feed the little baby doll, and she'll wrap the baby in a blankie, and I'm like, this little baby Joshy. So she's getting used to having a little baby brother. I cannot wait for that to all happen. But I'm still telling you about why my wife is more tired than I am, and you may have noticed I'm pretty sleepy. So that was that match. That was the entire match in the mouse. That's what happens when you hold down the capture zone. And this is Derptenk just being his own incredible self in one of the biggest meme aircraft in this game. In fact, the biggest aircraft in this game, the BV-238, which really speaks for itself, and because this aircraft and this match speak for themselves, enjoy the visuals. I'll go back to enjoying this mental state that I'm in right now. Super sleepy mode. I remember, and I invite you to hearken back to the early days of this here YouTube channel, where at 2 a.m. while I'm waiting for baby Brooklyn, who was an actual little baby instead of just being my baby. Oh, tail controls are out. He's spiraling to his death. What can he accomplish on the way down? But baby Brooklyn was... she was an all-night feeder, so she would wake up like every 2 hours and want another bottle. The girl was voracious, so I would stay up and I would make up bottles for her to drink, and so I'd be up at like 2, 4 a.m. waiting on a baby, and I would make silly videos on YouTube, which are the heart of the first videos of this channel. And I kind of miss those times where I would just be super silly and sleep deprived and stupid. And I hope again you enjoy this Sky Pirate gameplay in the BV-238. It's just one of those aircraft that there's nothing like it, and that's probably a good thing. In any event, I might have gotten a little bit distracted. I'm a whole lot tired today. And what else is there left to say? I'm sort of losing my train of thought here. Hopefully I'll be able to find some restful sleep, but there's no rest for the wicked, and there's no respite for a BV-238 pilot. You just end up being everybody's favorite pinata, and the ludicrous amount of defensive guns on your aircraft give you a fighting chance at filling the sky with Christmas ornaments and hoping that some of those set fire to the enemy. The BV-238. Ridiculous bomb load, high altitude spawn, not at all the kind of survivability that it used to have when it was first introduced, along with the serious reduction in survivability of most aircraft in the game at around that time, especially heavy bombers and other bombers. There used to be a day where you could just put literally hundreds of cannon rounds into the BV-238's massive wings, fuselage, and or tail and not take the thing down. Those were glorious times. It might have been the first time I got an ace in this game, at least in the air. And I hesitate to use the term ace. Anybody ever call themselves a bomber pilot ace? And no, Stuka, you may not into ace. It's a different situation entirely, but a multi-crew bomber. Who gets the ace then? Is it the hero gunner? I think they just want to complete their missions and go home. But there's only one way home for an Axis flying boat crewman, and it's a downward spiral. In any event, that was... who was that? Derptenk? That was Derptenk. Sorry. I'm very sleepy. I might have mentioned that. But now we have Rose, RosehipSan, in the Stug 3 with the long 75mm cannon that makes German tanks at this tier so fun and so competitive, with more or less 80 millimeters of frontal armor plating, flat as you do, and yet still effective Excuse me. At this BR, got a little bit of a gyoza belch going on there. I cooked up some, I think other people might call them potstickers, but gyoza. I steam them to get them nice and soft. These are a frozen, what would you call them, rice dumpling, I guess, that you're supposed to steam. So I will, you sort of boil them in half the amount of water that it would take to immerse them in a skillet. And then I pan fry them a little while with some tasty teriyaki sauce, and they are delish. I had some gyoza tonight. I'm kind of feeling the munchies coming on here for a little midnight snackerino, but I got those. They would be pork and cabbage flavored belches coming up, so this is just a fun and exciting experience in general for me. And if you're wondering what I would sound like when I'm so tired that I start to sound a little bit high, welcome. This is as close to intoxicated as you'll find me, and it's just from the sleep signals that are being sent through my brain that I'm pointedly ignoring right now. I talked about how I was just gargling up lung fluid when I was laying down in bed. So that's not like, I don't want to think about that right now. The good news is, I've seen my future and I'm not going to die today, but I kind of feel like it. I really don't feel top right now, but oddly enough, and maybe you can relate to this, sometimes when you feel like death, it's kind of fun to share that, just to talk about how bad you feel with your friends. So, you know, I'm not saying that I feel like death just because you're around. That's not the case at all, my friends. In fact, I feel like death, and you guys make that fun. And you know what? Between that and War Thunder, maybe that's something we have in common. We, who are about to die, but always suffering playing this game, we salute you. The armor of Stug 3 coming through for Rose time and time again. ASU 57, more like ASCU later in Soviet Union pen indicates you. Yeah, it's late. Or is it even midnight yet? Let me check the time. It's only 10:30. I did mention that I took two sleeping pills, right? I'm a little bit sleepy. Melatonin. It's not the crazy sleepy pills. Any weird mental state is, that's just me being my true self. Anyway, RosehipSan, having lost a piece of sight and shirts, and is still pushing forward with the objective. This, obviously, his second life from the little indicator down there that you can see one death. And that is because I've edited this video a small bit, just a little bit. I'm sort of trying to get away from doing any more trying to get my tongue to wake up while I'm talking to you, than I absolutely have to. And yet, a little bit of snippety snip here, cutty cut there, does improve the final product considerably. More points, I suppose, in the camp of circumcision. Anyway, enemy popping around the corner and popping back into cover as you do, but RosehipSan not at all intimidated by the Valentine, taking him down with a single well-placed shot into the hull of the British medium tank, although I suppose the Brits didn't call them medium tanks, that does have a considerable amount of armor if you play your cards right, and yet against the upwards of 120 millimeters of armor penetration value that the Stug 3 has with this cannon. That's not going to make enough of a difference. The T-34, Russian Bias Mobile Mark 1 as well, succumbing to the overwhelming firepower of the Wehrmacht. Is it the Wehrmacht? What would you call obviously they are the Panzers. Once they are catching the enemy team with their Panzers down. but yeah. Panzer Jaeger? I feel like there's a Attack on Titan reference in there somewhere, but I'm way too sleepy to grab a hold of that one. In any event, BT-5, BT-7, he's gone, he's dead. There's no pun. Pun not found. You know I'm really sleepy when the dad jokes start to fail. And we are winding toward a close in this, with this. Fancy antlers, by the way. Loving them. Is that an enemy? Puma? Is it Germany versus Germany? I do believe that I don't know. Was that an ally? I don't have the video in my editing software big enough to see properly if that was an enemy vehicle. It is possible now for Germany to face Germany, which is a thing in realistic battles. Realistic mixed battles, lads and ladies. A brave new era of War Thunder. I just got done trying to record a rather entertaining replay sent in by Based God Garfield or something, whatever his name was. Someone that I think I met on the subreddit sent me a fantastic IL-2 replay. Beautiful ground strike in Air RB. Something that I really enjoyed watching while I thought I was recording the replay. But Gaijin borked the NVIDIA overlay once again with this latest update, so I actually have nothing. I have nothing. I didn't record anything. And I'll get around to that, even if I have to use OBS, because that was a great replay that Garfield's thick cheeks sent in to me. So that's all. This is the end of the video.